Hello there, guys. Today I'm going to be introducing you to a game by the name of Die Cryptor. Die Cryptor is an upcoming top-down action stealth game, and it happens to be in an interesting, futuristic, cube-like world. Now, I was asked by the dev to look at this game, and I find that it looks and feels quite interesting and pretty nice overall. To go through the levels, you take out bots guarding the hallways with your various weapons. These weapons range from a sword, a katana maybe, to some grenades, to these bombs you can plant, and then a simple pistol that you can shoot in short range. Now, all of this together involves a lot of tactical thinking and gameplay, as well as being smart about stealth and not getting caught and shot on sight. I thought the controls were a bit awkward going into it. You can only move in four directions, and then you will automatically aim at enemies when you get in close enough range. So there is a little automation going in terms of the gameplay. So that does mean a little bit less in terms of playing skill, and more in terms of just thinking stuff over and thinking in terms of positioning and timing, which is obviously to the taste of some and not so much to the taste of others. I like it personally, and it's obviously up to you to decide in the end. I still feel a little bit awkward with the controls, but not in any horrible way. Once you get the hang of it, it flows well enough. Additionally, the whole control scheme goes really well with the aesthetic scheme, which is made up of all straight lines. The aesthetic is really cool looking and futuristic, and gives that vibe I really like. It's cubic and has some nice 3D elements to it. I really like how some cubes and some sections just disappear whenever it's inconvenient for you to have them. I really like when games do things like that when they're in a top-down perspective. Sometimes the top-down perspective can lack some things compared to 3D games and games where you're over the shoulder or in first person. But if they're done right, I'd say I might even prefer the top-down perspective over other things. Like I mentioned, this game has that 3D element to it in some places, and different levels of the environment can't really be accessed by jumping into them or anything, because there is full fall damage, and making a jump will usually get you killed. Instead, stuff's usually accessed by ramps and elevators. So the amount of weapons you have, combined with the different scattered bots you'll come across in different positions, well, they lead to some nice tactical gameplay, and have you playing in that really tactical fashion if you want, or possibly avoiding all contact in a stealthier way. You have weapons that can stun enemies or distract them, so that is a legit way to do things. And then you could possibly just go all out rushing in with your sword and chopping them up, but that will have negative effects on your life. That strategic part makes it so I just die a lot anyway though, no matter what, so it doesn't really matter how I play. I will just end up in a ditch or shot up bloodily by some bots. Now, it's not perfect in its level design at this point, and it's not perfect at explaining itself, but I really do see some potential in the game, and hopefully a couple things get cleared up before it is fully released. But from what I've played of it so far, I really do see some great potential in it, and I really was having a lot of fun the whole time. And that is, well, nothing better can really be said about a game than that. A small demo of the game is available for your browser, which I'll link to below. It's really, really short, but it just gives you maybe a basic idea of how the game plays. And the game is also trying to get into Steam through Steam Greenlight at the moment, so I'll put a link to that below in the description as well, as this game is well deserving at a chance to get on that service, because that service can help a game be successful immensely. That's about all for now, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. I've been Maple Dungeons, and I will see you next time.